worship you. I live to worship you. I live to worship you. I don't need you to sit and stare at me. I need you to worship God. I'm not the center of your attraction. Jesus is. Lift up your head. Children, I greet you in the magnanimous name of Jesus. Let me tell you that I'm the least among all men. I don't consider myself anything. But one thing I do know is that I have a God who is everything.
Amen.
You happen to be in Rafa Christian Center today. It's been a long time coming. Well, I got to move expeditiously here. But I love Pastor Brown. Hello, Pastor Brown. Not because he's your Pastor Brown. But I love Pastor Brown for some 20 years ago when I came back to God. Because see, I'm one of those church kids that ran off, chased the dream, chased pro football and NCAA football. When God brought me back, when God brought, say, God bring you back. Don't worry about the kids when they leave. God will bring them back. I used to sit. And my memory of this man of God was exactly what God just did to you. He ran and he danced. And I remember him spinning. We were at Mount Zion Apostolic in Montreal. Bishop McKenzie. And I said, that's my bishop there. And I said, Lord, I love this man. Not because of his flesh, but he had something that connected me. I love them that love him and seek him. I wish I had a hurry to seek him. I didn't come to entertain, I come to get you going. I said, to praise God. To the man of God, Pastor Brian. We come from the same home church. That the United Church of Jesus Christ. So I can't bro. So I'm no novice.
Right? No.
I was born in this. And I was born for this.
Glory to God.
To the beautiful people. And Sister Renee, Lord, I gotta get going. Sister Renee. Now, Brother Andrew, I didn't have the privilege of meeting your son. But I was just checking him out, you know?
Yes, that's right.
Because I do check you out.
Yes,
you
do, yes.
I love him. Because he has some characteristics of his father.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Very humble. I love you.
Yes.
She came to preach for us.
Amen. Yeah, amen.
Convocation.
Yeah, amen.
She would have been a proud pastor.
Amen.
She did a magnum.
Yes.
An amazing job.
Amen.
This woman loves God.
Yes.
Come on, put your hands together for her. She loves God. And I wouldn't miss it for the world. I dropped everything to be here today. Well, it was really yesterday. But since I was here yesterday, I'm here today. Lord God, time is the essence. Now we gotta go. I gotta condense this because you know when God begins to speak, I don't know how God speaks to you. But when God begins to speak to me, I'm not intelligent enough
That's right.
To contain it.
That's right.
So I said, Do Lord, remember me.
Yeah.
But God, on the first day we went to fast and pray.
That's right.
I went to bed and God brought up Rafa. And God has a question for you, Rafa Christian Center, and all who God knew would be here.
That's right.
His question is, what am I saying to you now? What am I saying? So you hop up on your feet quickly to the book of and I can't do much. Go to the book of Isaiah 52 quickly. We just read two verses. So Paul, the Lord, you already know what the Lord said about you. Just continue in that way. Isaiah said something profound. Are you there?
Yes.
Isaiah 52. And I have a translated version. He said, awake, a wig. Put on your strength, O Zion. Put on your beautiful garments, O Jerusalem, the holy city. For there shall no more come into you the uncircumcised and unclean. Shake yourselves. Shake yourselves from the dust and arise. Be seated, O Jerusalem. Loose the bonds from off your neck, O captive, the daughter of Zion. I got to touch Matthew quickly. You don't have to get to Matthew 25. About the 10 virgins. I'll go through it quickly. Kingdom of heaven. Jump down to 5. So when the bridegroom was delayed, for there were 10 virgins, 5 was wise and 5 were foolish. When the bridegroom was delayed, they laid down, say all of them, to rest until midnight. When they arose at the sound, the bridegroom is coming. Come out and welcome him. They all jumped up and tripped their lamp. Then the 5 who had oil did not have oil, begged the others to share with them, for their lamps were going out. But the others replied, "We have enough. Go get your own stuff at the shop." But while they were gone, the bridegroom came. And those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast. The part that struck me was when they came back later and they knocked that door and said, "Sir, open up and let us in." Go away! It's too late. Listen to 13. So stay awake and be prepared. For you do not know the date or the moment of his return. In a time like this, when hell is set loose, the kingdom of God still stands. Father, in the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands to thee. Know the help I know. You are God, and you are God all by yourself. Who am I, God, to stand before you? Just a conduit, God. In the name of Jesus, Father, if you will use me, God, I'm ready. Sanctify me with your own self. Wash me thorough without within, so that the flow of your anointing may flow through my mouth into the ears and the heart of your people. Father, we understand that natural minds cannot understand spiritual things. Father, anoint their hearing. Help them to hear. Help them to understand. Help them to shout, "It's true, amen." Help them to say, "Lord, I hear to your call." Have your way in this place, Father. While you're working, bind up Satan. Bind up every evil. Amen. Contingent. Every arrow, every darkness, every suppression. Oh my God, every demon, every attaching spirit, every nocturnal spirit. I bind it up now. In the name of Jesus. Set the Lord people free. Move, Jesus. Sit on us in this place. We glorify you. We are you. We give you all the praise. Somebody who believes God in me shout in Jesus' name. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I'm not going to be long. I'm going to condense it all. But you know, when I preach, it's like 10 hours.
Yep, that's right.
Long in the church.
Blessed.
But people can't handle the word.
No, that's right.
But I still love the Lord. Yeah. And I'll always pursue. Hey, is it not true that we have been laboring in this salvation walk in an effort to win Christ?
Yes.
You're going to talk to me, right?
Yes, he can.
Is it not true that we have abstained from all manners of sinful and fleshly lusts to conform to the image of Christ?
Amen.
Is it not true?
Yes, it is.
Wouldn't I be right to assert that we have forsaken all to follow Jesus?
Amen.
I'm all by myself.
Go ahead.
The people of God. What if I were to tell you that the momentum that we have built to climb up this mountain called Christianity or walk with God is not enough? And all the things that we have done is not enough for us to hear, well done.
Amen.
Come on.
Why are we walking? Why are we doing this? Are we not doing this to hear?
Well done.
What if I were to tell you that there are areas in our lives where we are actually sleepwalking? Areas in our lives that have not acquiesced to the articulation of Jesus Christ's instructions for our lives. There are areas in our lives that are dead. Yet we walk with God and we are talking with God and we're praising. Yet there are some part of us that have not been touched.
Go ahead.
Take your time.
Our greatest problem in the 21st century in the Church of Jesus Christ is that we are engulfed in the vortex of the information highway.
Come on.
We're on the pathway of information. Notwithstanding, it is not the pathway that God has ordained.
Right.
I'm going to be in trouble for you.
Go ahead. It's all right.
Rather, it is a pathway called human supposition. Human, I suppose, you know, this is the way to go.
Go ahead.
And so what we have done, we have sheathed intellectualism over relationship.
Come on.
I'm used to preaching all by myself.
Go ahead.
If I say I don't need amen, I'm not
being rude.
Go ahead. You don't need it.
We have made a shift. And no more are we asking the Lord, what would you have me to do? We are now experts in intellectuality. What God called intellectual religion. For everybody now go to the house of God to hear some wonderful discourse of hermeneutics.
That's right.
Some phenomenal. You come in here, brother. Oh, you're very intelligent has nothing to do
with God.
Two masters later, okay. So I believe in education.
That's right.
School administrator, that means I'm strict.
That's right.
They don't play with me in school.
That's right.
I have adults, so I'm even more tough. I believe in education. I believe in higher education. As a matter of fact, I'm about to start the PhD.
Yes, amen.
But what does PhD have to do with Jesus?
Nothing. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Take your time.
Because now, Lord, I want to talk of our intellectual suppositions.
Go ahead.
We have become extremely self-directed.
Yes.
For now we know how to extrapolate.
Come on.
We know how to exegete Bible. I'm all by myself.
Go ahead.
Lord, I'm all. We know how to do it. You see, the reason why we do it, we extrapolate Bible to go back to look at what God did in order to anticipate what he's about to do.
Go ahead.
Come on.
They're going back now to use intellectuality to try to see the move of God. Because if you know the move of God, you don't have to ask what he's going to do next. Because God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. There's some patterns in God that have not changed. There's some patterns in God that will not change. So man, instead of going after God, go after intelligence.
Right, come on.
Praise God.
Go ahead.
I was talking to the Lord the other day and said, Lord, why you can't give me something sweet to preach? I want to preach that pretty stuff too.
Oh, Lord. No, sir.
Praise God.
The Lord said the other day, he said, Andrew, they've gone back into the Old Testament.
Come on.
Yeah. Extrapolated from the Old Testament.
Right.
They look back at what I've done.
Right.
And then they go into the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
And they dig through the gospel. And they're looking.
Searching.
Come on. For what he did.
Right.
He walked on water. He healed the blind. And then they jump over. They dare to jump over into the book of Acts. Because they said, well, we want to know how to get into the church.
That's right.
They've gone swimming into the church.
Right.
Know how to get into the church.
Oh,
yes. And then they jump all the way into the epistles. Don't look at me. This is how God talks to me. And they're in the epistles now. Because they ought to know that when you get into the church, you need to know how to stay in the church. And then they go through and they're searching. And then they dare now to jump over into the revelation. Because I need to know what's coming. And they're extrapolating. And they're using soteriology and God, theology and eschatology and every allergies. I seem to think they got some allergies, but they're going and they're searching, trying to do it their own
way. That's right.
But I submit to you today what the Holy Ghost said to me. The Holy Ghost came to me and asked a simple question. Understand something about chewing up stale word. word will put you to sleep.
All right.
You see, if I eat the stale bread, it blows me.
Yes.
And it puts me down to sleep. Transliteration here is that if I did my own intellectual research, I don't need a word from God. And so what happened there is that I fall asleep because I'm full. I think I know God. I don't even need a preacher.
Go ahead.
I don't need that because I know God talks to me.
Go ahead.
Come on, mighty God. Yes, yes, yes.
The Lord is speaking to us. He said, you can't make it without me.
That's right.
Without me, you can do absolutely
nothing.
I said something for you. It talks about these 10 virgins.
Mm-hmm. I'm hurrying to my clothes here.
Mm-hmm. It talks about these 10 virgins.
Yes,
I want to let you know that these 10 virgins, none of them were sinners.
That's why they're virgins. That's why they're
virgins. None of them were backsliders. Nobody of the 10 didn't praise God.
Come on.
Nobody of the 10 didn't fast. None of the 10 didn't praise. None of the 10 didn't dress modestly. None of the 10, oh God, didn't do the Christian ritual. Every last one of them was a church member and a part of the kingdom of God.
Come on.
They were
Come on.
And you don't pray. Well, you better talk back to me.
Yes.
You don't have time when you told God, Lord, I'm going to fast next week, but next week never came.
Come on,
Baba Shah. You don't have time. He said, Lord, if you deliver me, I'm going to stay on my face, but you always stayed up and never got down. And you remember those times? Those times are times when you get derailed.
Yes.
So you can sit in the presence of God and still be derailed. You can be in the presence of God. Brother Andrew, you can be in the presence of God, clapping your hands and still disconnected. You can be worshiping like an angel, but God don't know you. But he knows no man after the flesh. And the minute you get derailed, you are derailed into the flesh. I'm all by myself. And if you have those Christian tendencies, it's all fleshly tendency and not spiritual tendency. And so God don't know you. That's why you can't just do casual church. You can't just go to church casually and say, the Lord loved me and I know it. He calls the blessed to rain on the just and the unjust. God is no respecter of persons. God don't only bless the one who knows him, but he blesses everybody. So you can't use that as a qualification that God is with you. I'm all by myself here. Why don't you casual relationships?
Okay. Go ahead.
The couple didn't marry yesterday to have a casual relationship.
Go ahead.
They got married to have an intimate, close, just a closer walk with the granted Jesus. He's my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be the Lord. Where you go, I'll go. Where you Lord, I love. Your people shall be my people. And your God.
Ten virgins. Take your time.
Oh,
they were praising God.
Amen.
They were praising God. There's something that happens to the church of Jesus Christ. Preachers, children of God, everybody falls asleep.
Oh, Jesus.
It didn't say only five fell asleep.
All of them.
Sometimes you might be preaching and people just can't receive because they're tuned out. Everybody falls asleep. Oh, Lord, I got to check myself before I ring myself. I've got to check myself. I got to be checking myself. I've got to be pinching myself. Because sometimes I feel very sleepy.
Come on, yeah.
Sometimes I don't want to pray. Sometimes I don't want to sing. Sometimes I don't want to fast. Sometimes I want to reach out to God. Sometimes my situation makes me so mad that I don't even want to pray. But the key here, the key here is what will you do to accrue such a relationship with God that even when you do fall asleep, when the trumpet of God shall sound,
glory.
when you be able to hear him.
Holy Ghost.
See,
take your time.
My dad.
My God.
I should be filled with seeking God to keep my lamp.
Come on.
Lord, I wish I had some help. The Bible said they trimmed their lamp. I'm from Kinston, so I'm from the concrete jungle. So I ain't gonna come up here and lie like I know something about the country here. But I know a little bit about lamps. Can I be down here, sir? I know a little something about lamps. I'm all by myself here, but if somebody would just pray for me, one of you two here, just pray for me, God, we'll do the rest. I know something about lamps. I know that when kerosene oil was high, back in Jamaica, we couldn't afford it. And so we had to go easy on it. Come on, by myself here. And so you can't just turn it up full blast. You can't be shining all over the room. You just gotta trim it. We know something. We don't go out there and try to kill a team in the first period. When you kill them in the first period, you run out of steam.
That's right.
And by the time the third comes around, Lord, you're on your back, they're stepping in your head, they're crushing you. Because you put everything in the first run. The Bible never said run fast. He said run. Insert something powerful.
Come on now. Yes.
You need divine
instruction.
Because if I'm going based on my intelligence, I make suppositions. I pull on math and equations and physics. I pull all it out because I've got to do it my way. You know how the intellectuals are. They do it their way. They pull their own graphs and their own scheme, and they have their own way to measure systems and to measure, and they do it their own way. But when you do it your own way, you are a failure.
Yeah, that's right.
I need God to tell me at what level to trim it. I need God to tell me when to turn it up.
Yes, right.
When to turn it down.
Yeah.
I'm all by myself.
Go ahead.
I need God to talk to me.
Yes.
Daily.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's right.
One day, I feel troubled.
Yes.
I need God to talk to me. So God says that we, the church, have been doing it our way. We've been doing it our way. We've fallen asleep too early. And what we have allowed when we fall asleep is every unrighteousness to walk through the doors. Oh, you know I'm a holiness preacher. I'm going to preach holiness. I've been a holiness preacher all my life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We have allowed everything to walk in. How do you know if a church is sleeping? Everything creeps in.
Everything.
And you call it holy.
Holy. Go ahead.
God never said, Andrew, you're going to have 10,000.
No, you won't have it.
When you preach holiness, ain't nobody gonna say amen. That's but I still right. Preach the gospel.
Amen. Amen.
You know when a church is sleeping, when everything creeps in I walked in here for the first time yesterday.
Oh, glory to God.
And I sat down. And my sister was bellowing. Lord, she said, oh, Lord.
Amen.
She touched something down there.
Yes.
But I heard God and I said, she is clean, God says. I can't help it, Pastor. This is what happened to me. God says she's clean, but I want her to come up higher. For what she has can turn this city upside down. Yes, that's a sister. Why do you think the heavens is never quiet? Why do you think God ordained or adorned Satan with all those musical instruments? Why do you think there's always saying, holy, holy, holy?
Sleeping
to your life.
That's right.
I'm all by myself.
Come on.
The devil is not your friend. I'm all by myself here. The devil doesn't come into your life to befriend you, to give you anything. He comes into your life to chain you up. He comes to bound you. He comes to put shackles. He comes to put things around your neck. He comes to lock you up. The devil is a lie. And so he's going to allow every ungodliness to come in. What I heard, I heard.
You know when you're in the spirit. You know God.
that is a word for here. I have to deliver it.
Go ahead.
But out of discipline and respect, we got to go to the proper protocol.
That's right.
Oh, we already know how God works.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
God said,
yes.
I said, I need to hear you.
Now!
I heard, four in the morning. I look over. My mentor is calling from Australia.
Mighty God.
Mighty God. He's
calling
from Australia.
Yes.
He said, yes.
You
called?
Mighty God.
Jesus.
Mighty God.
Mighty
God. He said, I come to give you a word, Andrew. God says, awake.
Yeah.
God.
Confirm
God.
The word.
God, shut up.
Thank you.
Come on. This is ironic. He said, no. It is God.
It's God.
Yes.
4 in the morning.
Yes.
Praise God. From Australia, sir.
From Australia.
Come on. Come on.
That's a whole different time zone. A whole different world. I don't know how to get there.
Come
on. Thank you, Jesus. Call me.
Come on.
Because I told God I need you.
Now.
Where the radicals in this house?
Yeah.
Where the radicals? I want to see your spirits. Where the radicals in this house? Where the now? I need you now, Jesus. Where the dog is here? You all been nervous? There's some nervous people. You don't believe that God can? I've seen cancer healed. At least 3 people in the last 2 months that walked through with my life. Got their hands laid on and the cancer left.
Thank you.
I pray for you this morning.
Yes. Thank you.
even in just that your yay be yay
and your nay be nay.
God just speaks, brother. Got somebody here. All he needs you to do is just praise and keep your focus. Let God confirm His word. Let God confirm His word. Come on, let God confirm His word. Come, 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 come. Come on, let's pray for the elders. If you feel like you've been sleeping for it, if you have not heard a word from God in a while, don't hide behind the screens. Don't hide behind your pride. Don't hide behind your human intellectuality. Don't hide behind pretension. Pride cometh before and a hard spirit. Come, come, come. Side down. Come on, ministers, come. Come on, mothers.
Thank you. forever.